Hey there, it's Stephanie Shea, Chief Astrologer for JanSpiller.com with your monthly horoscope, and this one's for you, Sagittarius. I'm happy to report that August is one of the few months in 2020 with no inner planet retrogrades. So with the inner planets being Mercury, Venus, and Mars, we have a lot of that going on this year. We just got done with Venus retrograde in May and June, on top of Mercury retrograde that came in towards the end of June into the middle of July. And we got through June and July eclipses. So a lot of heavy astrology just happened. This is like a little breathing room before Mars goes retrograde in September. So I encourage you to maximize this, especially for you Sagittarius as a fire sign. You're really getting a boost this month from Mars in Aries, another fire sign. It's a good time to focus on your goals and initiate some action. The official Mars retrograde dates are September 9th to November 14th. We have entered the shadow phase of this already, but that's about as good as it gets this year. And as long as you are cautious, you can get some things done. Now here's the ground rules for getting things started during Mars retrograde shadow period. Avoid impatience. Mars and Aries wants things done yesterday. You're going to need to be realistic about your time and your resources and avoid making impulsive moves. Instead, put your efforts towards something that you've been thinking about for a long time. That way you probably already have a few of the pieces in place, a few ideas about what could go wrong and how to avoid that. It's okay if you don't know all the details of getting from A to B just yet. Just take some small steps this month. Plan to revise and refine your ideas in the coming months as you'll be learning more. Now we've got the full moon this month in Aquarius on August the 3rd. That's going to activate your mind, and it's a great time to receive and analyze information. You're going to be scheduled for some inspiration that could really help you to see an old problem in a new light. This great timing at this Aquarius full moon for an aha moment, and you finally figure out the solution to something that has been blocking you. It's a good time to innovate ways to get more freedom in your daily life. This could be by taking charge of your time, and it could also signify the completion of a group project or educational program. We've got Mercury moving into Leo on August the 4th. This is also activating your mind. A lot of this month's astrology is about your intellect and learning this month, Sagittarius. Mercury in Leo is great for your communications, and you might find yourself wanting to research some faraway places or talk to people from different countries and cultures. The adventurous side of Sagittarius is really being stimulated now, and it's more difficult to travel during this pandemic. And so instead of actually going on a trip around the world, you might find yourself reading travel books, watching films, and doing things that help to rekindle your sense of adventure without having to go out there. Now, we've got Venus in Cancer on the 7th, and that's going to put an emphasis on intimacy and emotional connection. There could be a focus on romantic partnership and any close relationship, really, where there is a strong emotional bond. This astrology is encouraging honesty, open communications, open-hearted relations, and it's really a time to be gentle with yourself and others and consider what you need to create a safe emotional space for you and your loved ones. That's what Venus in Cancer is asking of you this month. Now, this month's new moon is on August the 18th. It's at 26 degrees of Leo. And Sagittarius is a fire sign just like Leo. So you're going to really have some power working with this new moon. You'll be especially supported to set intentions related to teaching and learning, spirituality, romantic partnerships, and creative pursuits. And if you're wondering about the best time to set these new moon intentions, not just any old time on the day of the new moon, but what's most powerful windows of time, I encourage you to check out janspiller.com and become a member, because then you'll gain access to these special intention setting times around the new moon. And this is something that was Jan Spiller's life work. She wrote the book New Moon Astrology, and it really can help you manifest what you want when you work with each new moon in this way. So be sure and check that out. We've got the sun entering Virgo on the 22nd. This could light up the area of your chart having to do with career or public image, especially if you are Sagittarius rising. And the end of the month is going to be a great time to take some new steps related to existing or potential employment, or putting yourself out there in some way before Mars stations retrograde on September the 9th. So I hope you can make the most of this month's astrology. Be safe and be well, and I'll see you here next month with your horoscope.